dog pose with variations. Come on to the floor on your hands and knees. Set your knees directly below your hips and your hands slightly forward of your shoulders. Spread your palms, index fingers parallel or slightly turned out, and turn your toes under. Exhale and lift your knees away from the floor. At first, keep the knees slightly bent and the heels lifted away from the floor. Lengthen your tailbone away from the back of your pelvis and press it lightly towards the pubis. Against this resistance, lift the sitting bones towards the ceiling, and from your inner ankles, draw the inner legs up into the groins. Then with an exhalation, push your top thighs back, stretch your heels onto or down toward the floor. Strengthen your knees, but be sure not to lock them. Firm the outer thighs and roll the upper thighs inward slightly. Narrow the front of the pelvis. Firm the outer arms and press the bases of the index fingers actively into the floor. From these two points, lift along your inner arms from the wrists to the top of the shoulders. Firm your shoulder blades against your back. Then widen them and draw them towards the tailbone. Keep the head between the upper arms. Don't let it hang. Adho Mukha Svanasana is one of the poses in the traditional sun salutation sequence or the Surya Namaskara. It's also an excellent yoga asana all on its own. Stay in this pose anywhere from 1 to 3 minutes. Then bend your knees to the floor with an exhalation and rest in child's pose. The benefits of Adho Mukha Svanasana or the dog's pose: calms the brain and helps to relieve stress and mild depression. Energizes the body. Stretches the shoulders, hamstrings, calves, arches and hands. Strengthens the arms and legs. Helps relieve the symptoms of menopause. Relieves menstrual discomfort when done with head supported. Improves digestion. Relieves headache, insomnia, back pain and fatigue. Therapeutic for high blood pressure, asthma, flat feet, sciatica and sinusitis.